How?
Listen, one of my students that I dealt with last 2 weeks, you know, you can be watching this video now. I was in his house and he was saying, oh, Tani, I'm going to start. I heard how you are seeing people are talking about rental and all that. So when I said, okay, what do you want? I said, but Tani, the other day, my father had a house in the Art of Surulere. And this house that my father had in the Art of Surulere, my father was making this amazing thing, okay, listen to me. My father was making 500,000 every year from this rental in the Art of Surulere. I mean, the eyebrow of Surulere. Now, as at 2 years ago, now, so he came in and he looked at it and he did some renovation on the house. The house that was giving his father 500K every year, the father giving him 1.3 million every year. Then the father thought, he has did a miracle. Do you understand? The father called him. The father was watching what happened. And after 2 days, I said, you already have a seed of rental income. Do you understand? You already have a seed of rental income. I said, do you see how much, you see, rental income is not a magic, but its effect is magical. You can see how ability to change something little move you from 400 to 500K. Do you know how many percentage is that? From the same house. It did not go any other place. From the same house. So when someone was saying that if that till is land, is asset, will be satisfied with bread. That means a lot of people are missing that out because they don't look at it. And so when you talk something, people can get angry. People can look at you and say, yeah, are you trying to say we don't want to know how to sell in the market again? When you're saying, oh, appreciation, when you're saying, oh, don't buy land for this, don't buy land for that. Like we have often said on this, you know, that conversation. The truth, one of the reasons why you want to own a land is because you just edge your money. That's all.
Yeah.
There's nothing more because you have not found out something to do with it right now. So you want to edge it because inflation counts every single time. So you are edging the money by buying a property that you know that, okay, when I'm ready to use my money, I mean, inflation will not have prorated the money.
Yeah.
I cannot. That is the essence of saying you want to get a land. But beside that, what you should be looking for, because sometimes, the reason why people don't want to go for cash, the reason why a lot of people take cash, because cash flow is the hardest kind of investment to go for. Anybody can sell an investment to you. Every other investment is easy to find, but cash flow, it takes a sophisticated financial education to find a cash flow deal. And that's why a lot of people don't get it. So everybody can say, buy this and do this one.
Which is why I was saying last week that a lot of people don't know about rental income. A lot of people think it's a new invention. It's a new discovery. It's not a new discovery, but a lot of people don't know about it because it's cash flow. Rather, people know about stock. People know about bonds. Treasury bills, all those things. People know all those things because it's everywhere. You can easily locate it. But cash flow is where the major problem is. Even up to today, if you tell people cash, if you tell people rental income, they don't understand what you're saying.
You know, in Georgetown University, about 50 years ago, in Georgetown University, they discovered something. They discovered that people in India, they had these tamas. And they are wondering, why is this so? And they realized that there is no worse tamri in the dictionary. In other words, the language that you are used to determines your stamina. So that means if you don't get used to the word, you know, rental income, you see, words don't come to you, you go for it. Because you see, you can't, that's why all the English word we are using today were the one that I've sorted. Maybe somebody spoke it and you're wondering, what's the meaning of this? You try to find it out. And you know what, you don't go there because your language affects your IQ.
True.
So if you don't use, if you don't understand the word, you cannot explore it.
Somebody asked me, but just while I was here, just waiting, somebody still asked me what is rental. Yesterday, somebody still asked me
what is rental.
2 days ago, there is no day
that you don't get to.
That I
don't
get
that
to
question.
Hear that question.
So where's my car, by the way?
Cash flow.
Where is it?
Which one is that one?
There's no rental income in the office, my friend. Rental income is on the street. Go together.
I told you that.
Cash to me, I need cash to come.
So the idea is not, and just like what you said, it's not that it's a, but because the process is sophisticated. It takes a like what you said, like what you correctly do here now. So I go, and they have an office of maybe like 7 bedrooms or 6 bedrooms. So I too want to go and get the same. But he has been able to figure out
how to
make sure that thing is very, very valuable. Because it's not about the resource, it's not about the potential of a property. Because if I buy a property because of potential, that means what if everybody starts doing that same thing in the market? That's why selling people have properties, even in VI. And it seems that they are losing out.
Yeah.
Some properties, I just look at some properties in VI and I'm wondering, what are people doing this property? It's not enough for a property to have potential. It is for me as the owner or probably as an investor to be able to see the potential that this property has. So no property will ever lose in value. Except me, I begin to lose my level of creativity to see how that thing can work out. So the property is not the problem. The problem is that, okay, what am I seeing in this property? What kind of other opportunities can I use this property for? Like that thing that James designed. Somebody else might be saying, you know, like, sometimes I try to tax his head just to tell you that, okay, this thing may not be possible for us to design this particular stuff. But he said, no, can we do 32 units? Can we just play with it? No, we may not even get approval, we'll sort it out. If it is when we have seen design that we're going to sort it out. But, and so you can just go and, okay, let us just explore it. Why? Because you want, this is one plot of land, but I want to do 32 families on it. And I also want each of them to have car parks. How do you make it happen? Without it, so it is now left for me. So like somebody has 30 million, the person is thinking of a house. But what are you thinking about? It's basically a personal house. But what you are, because you are rental income minded, you are thinking of, okay, this 30 million naira, okay, Ajahu, what will I do with Ajahu? 11 million naira every year. So the first year, I have made
more than 50%.
I've made like 70% of my money. The second year, I'm making another 70%. The third year, I can't buy the property in Ajahu. I go buy the property in
Ajahu.
Because it's my asset buying for me. You know what? You can continue again. And I can take that same money and reinvest it somewhere else. But what most people, and that's why I started that series, that people are giving up on their money. Because why? They're not using creativity.
Yeah.
So they have a property, they're not like, okay, so you know what?
Just there.
I take a property, I come to rent a particular property that I don't really. If I go to rent a house, bro, I'm going to use all of it for studio.
Straight up.
It's going to be my income generating house. I'm not renting the house. I'm not, if I go to rent a 7-bedroom house, bro, it's everywhere.
Yeah, straight up.
It's most room must generate income for me. It's not because of the fact that this thing. Somebody was asking me yesterday that why are you exposing yourself? I'm exposing myself because I want to get attention. And the reason why you can send me a mail, it happens to be my pastor in church, one senior pastor in church. Because the reason why you are sending me this mail right now is because I've got your attention. So everything that one is doing, you must be able to look at what is the economic benefit of this thing. The economic benefit of my money, this is my seed. So some people are not even looking that way. So it's so like what we said the other time, it's not that maybe money hasn't come to people. Money has come, but the way people spend it, what they spent it on. I see a lot of people, you know, somebody was telling me, said that if I knew the money that I used to buy a property in the village, the guy is evil. When I used to buy a property, said he only lives in that house maybe just once a week. And I've been living there because you can't travel and go and spend the entire December in the village. So you travel just once a week with your family, just 7 days. And he spent about 17 million naira putting up that structure.
Wow.
Today, he has no job.
He built it
for 70 million, yeah. Stock it, furnish the property. Yeah, you furnish the property that's going to every year, you're sleeping on the bed. And you're sleeping on the bed. You have to come and clean the bed, maybe 2 weeks ahead of time. Ask people to come and clean a bed for you. Then there are no reason, just once a year. So and that's why that this particular area of financial education comes to play. Because a lot of people are people that are making money. So some people tell you that they want to make money. It's not true. They are making money from something. They are doing something because Nigerians are hustlers. Most people don't depend on their salary. But it's just that what people now do with that money is the issue. The things that they do. Because if I know that somebody 18 months, he has not been paid salary, how is he surviving? Government has not paid him salary.
That's the question most people have
done. Yes, the part is not that maybe it's not about major of us, it's not hustling. The major thing is that, okay, what do I do with that money? What am I doing with the money? So if somebody is now seeing you like, okay, what are they talking about? Creator income and all of that. They don't even understand all those things. Why? Because they don't want to understand because they don't know how to use their money well.
And it takes more from you to even learn financial independence in terms of cash flow, in terms of rent. rental income, like you said earlier. People would rather put their money in stocks. People would rather put their money in bonds. So I have a client who built different projects within my former estate, almost 10 projects, block of flat terraces, semi-detached houses. And today, he owns only one out of all of these houses because he didn't discover on time.
It's a slaughterhouse. And when you understand a slaughterhouse, you will realize why. You see, to be rich is predictable, and to be broke is also predictable. You see, you don't need to be a soothsayer to know somebody that will not be, make it. I mean, if you understand that, okay, you have 100,000. And that's why the world of money is so amazing, that somebody that is uneducated in your world, in schooling, the woman understands that, okay, for money, you see, money is an amazing servant. Money is useless if you don't give it value. So money likes to go to people that understand multiplier's effect. Now, most of us, when we buy something, what we do is we think like a slaughterman, not a diary maker, whereby you buy a car. You can do two things. You see, the option is available for you when you buy a car. Two options are available for you. You kill it or you make it. It's available to anybody. You don't need to go to school. You know, the same way, when money comes to your hand,
you kill it
or you multiply it. It comes to you all the time. Now, that is what makes you human. The moment you think that somebody else is will make that choice for you, you are a little like a robot.
Yeah.
Because the what makes you human is to know, I will milk it, I will not kill it. Now the question is, so a lot of people, the first money that most people have, they want to jump at that money to say they want to invest. So they get to it. Rather than carry that money to invest in their financial education. To not say, because truly please, show me, how can I master seeing opportunity so that I can multiply myself and I begin to grow? That is it. That is why a man can carry all the money he has and invest it. Now, I said to people, I said there are three things that make Grant Cardone, that make Michael Siva, that make Tiny Cash, that make Trudy, and that make Peacemaker the same. You know what is that? We carry all the money we have first and foremost, and we invest it into ourselves. And the money we invest into ourselves, you know what happened? Then begin to help us to get investment that begin to pay us. Because ultimately, it's about having investment that pays you. And that means, because all of us, forever, we always have expenses. It is the financial problems of life. You cannot go out of it. So when somebody tells you truly tomorrow morning that he has a financial problem, he's still saying, I have an expense that is more than my income. He's not saying any other thing, he doesn't just know how to say it. It is a more brutal way, it's a more courteous way to say it, as I have a financial problem. Because when you say I have an expense that is more than my income, the person will know that he's financially stupid. So if the person does not want to sound being financially stupid, they will not say I have a financial problem. They will break it down. The reason why you have a financial problem, it's because your expenses is more than your income. Now what you need to work on is your income producing asset, your income producing skill that will now supersede your regular expenses. That is it. People kill it. People carry money and go and build their house.
Do it now.
Do you understand? People just do that.
They can post it later.
No, people don't buy things. People say, oh man, when I was 13 years old, I built my house. I started saying, it's a cultural thing.
It's a cultural thing, and it's a defect.
It's a cultural thing. So people feel, just the way people say, oh, I'm married now. You are a girl, you're not married. Me, I'm married. It's a cultural thing. And that's what I said to people. You see, now you are complaining, you are running around the street that your wife has not given birth. As much as very sensitive and very nice, that could be. Why not best sort out your financial life so that when your child comes, you can properly take care of that child? People don't think in those two ways because we are culturally carried away and think, oh, so we are wondering now. So, like what you are saying, truly, I'm this figure. The point is, people need to know how to multiply, how to send their money to work. And that is what financial education is all about. Because most people work for money all their life, they never know how to put their money to work. What they now do is they transfer their financial responsibility into the hand of a man that calls himself a financial advisor or by selling stocks to them. Or known to them that what they call financial advisor is a courteous way of saying a man that is selling stocks. It's not bad. I was in one of these financial institutions the other day, asset management, and I was asking questions of the man that was selling the market. He could not answer me. He was wondering, what kind of strange man is this one? You understand? I was asking him some words. He doesn't even know. Because most people understand what I'm saying. And that is the man that you are calling to come and take care of your financial destiny. Oh, that is rubbish, man. I left the guy table. He was looking at me. That's why this guy, I don't even know what he's doing. Now, if I don't know, that's how I would have collected, put my money on him, and then maybe hope it. And hope is for the hopeless. And that's why it is, you know, hope is the language of a man that has no where he's going. So it put his financial destiny on hope. Now, maybe we shall make it.
One day.
One day, we will buy the property, we shall make it.
We will buy the car.
One day, we shall, you know.
We shall travel.
One day, we'll be able to do this. One day, God will do it. Our time shall come. About a few months, we'll go to the end of the year, and most people will go to the wonderful churches and all of that. And then the man of God sincerely and intentionally, you know, with all sincerity of heart, will declare to them that this coming year will be a year of new dawn, you know, everyone open on you, this and that. The man is very sincere. But you know what? Those words will not change your life. You have to take those words. You have to look at your life. Some people's life is already going down the drain because all they make is all they spend. They're not thinking about what can be paying them. Pension, there's pension crisis. Why? Because the question of pension is simple. How can these people keep paying their bill when they stop working? That is what led to retirement plan.
Yeah.
In other words, so the cause of the problem, we are not addressing.
Yeah, we are only addressing.
Do you understand?
Only addressing a governmental plan.
Do you understand?
For which they want to take. And you know, and the truth of the matter is that, I think I was telling somebody this week, I said that the pension of the people currently working, they've stolen it already.
No, let me even tell you the worst part of pension. The worst part of pension is not even that somebody has stolen it. The worst part of pension is that they are not paying you with interest.
Pension is savings.
Savings.
Now, there's a new pension plan. Now, you know, the people who get it. Now, there are two kinds of pension plan. Before now, in the days of our fathers, they are doing a definite benefit pension plan. What does that mean to a layman, an everyday guy on the street? It means that government says, when you stop working, we will pay you till you die. That is what we mean by definite benefit plan. You will pay you till you die. That means they will be paying you, they will rate you based on the grade you were when you were working, and they will be paying you that salary every month till you die. Now, when you now die, that is the end. Now, but after a while, government realize that there is no money. With the financial institution that also want to make money for themselves, then they collide and say, okay, let's create another plan. And I said, okay, what can we play? Let's create a contribution plan. I mean, they will not create what we call contribution pension plan. Now, what does contribution pension plan mean? Contribution pension plan means say that, Mr. A, you are working with Company C. You will contribute social percentage. Those who complete will contribute this percentage. That means when you retire, the money that have been put together by both you and him, okay, will now be given to you. Now, what that means is they never consider the inflationary plan. They never consider all of those things. That means if you look at it this way, you have all your plans, everything for all the years you have worked. Maybe you have 4 million in that pension plan. You now retire. The pension plan will now give it to you, the 4 million. Your monthly expenses is 150,000. Look at it, that's where the data, that's where the crisis is. The monthly expenses is 150,000 and you have 4 million in that. Now, when you are collecting the money, when you are putting the money there, they have told you that that money is tax exempt. There's even between tax exempted, do you understand, and tax deferred. Now, this is not tax exempted, it's tax deferred. They have deferred your tax till when you will collect the money. So the day you are not collecting your 4 million naira, they will not remove the tax from it. Now, I mean, maybe ultimately you now collect 3.5. Now, the monthly expenses is 150. So the question is, how many years, and you are 55 now, how many years I want to live to 75 or 85? How many years will you spend 3.5 million before you finish?
Max 2.5 years.
Max 2.5 years. That means you are just 55. So by the time
you can't buy property,
listen, sir. By the time you are 57, the money is finished. I want to live till 50. Because they know that
when you live to 60, they
know that when you are very poor, you will die. So they already know that. That's already part of the plan. So you collect the money, you finish. So your life, you now begin to become a frustrated human being because you are now frustrated on the economy, you are frustrated on the people, you are frustrated on the society, you are frustrated on your family, claiming that you have served the government all your life. Nobody is taking care of you. Because you know why? It is a dangerous experiment to expect people to take care of you. you must take care of yourself. Whatever you have been given power to do, no one can do for you.
And the reality is that you cannot even trust the system that is irresponsible.
True.
It's the way you expect.
So
let us even leave the fact that you've made a very salient point, and I believe that people, anybody who probably will listen now, will begin to see reason. And there's also another system where I'm transferring the right of my financial future. I'm transferring into the hands of somebody that has not even yet figured out his own finances.
Mm-hmm.
Because there are people who call out, somebody says, it's meant under the salary, but he said, what is his name? He says he's a politician. He said, profession? He says he's a politician. He said, do you do politics? He says he's a professional politician. You understand? So a lot of people are like that. And so you have put your finances in the hands of somebody else that does not even figure his own. Then you now begin to get to a particular age, you begin to beg, you begin to castigate the economy. The economy wasn't the problem. The problem has been that let me use the word now, I was very financially stupid where I was working. Do you understand? Because a lot of people, and I said something this morning, a lot of people disrespect their finances. They don't respect their money. So if money comes into my hand, what is the first thing I want to do? But you disrespect it by just, like what you said, by just killing it. By just spending it. Because the first thing people want to do is as if maybe they have this addiction called spendaholism. Whereby, you know what, it's to spend. Instead of me to invest. Because it's not true, not like that. Somebody will be looking at you and say, how did you start? How do you have what you currently have today? They're tracing everything. 90% of it or 99% of it because you invested in something. So it's not because of the fact that you, because that's what will make any poor person, individual who come from a poor background, to be able to become financially free. It's not about whether and people who are rich, their children can likely become poor because of the fact that they are rich, but because of the fact that they stop investing, they stop doing what makes people rich. So the real issue for most people is because they're not doing the same thing that ought to make them rich. A lot of people are disrespecting themselves. So like what you said yesterday, somebody has no job. The first thing he needs to think about is that what do I need to do to be able to ensure that money comes into my life? That's the first thing. Then when money comes into my life, where do I channel it into? But you know what somebody does? He sleeps by 7 a.m. in the morning. He's still snoring. He's still tying up as a man. He's still tying up by 8 a.m. Then the toothbrush. It's not even doing this privately. It's not going out
in front of
the house. And chew this thing. You know what? We disrespect ourselves by doing all those things. I know what the economy will also disrespect you by giving you poverty. Because you are disrespecting yourself. So the problem is not the economy, the problem is myself. I disrespect myself, I dishonor myself, I dishonor myself.
So it's not because somebody is richer than you that the person is disrespecting you.
It's not
because somebody is older than you that the person is disrespecting you. It's simply because you have disrespected yourself.
But not being financially educated.
Give everybody the opportunity and the right.
Yes, to
disrespect you.
So I have money, for example, if I work with, and I said something yesterday, if I work with Tadi, for example, maybe I'm working with him as an employee. What will make Tadi love me? Except he's not a smart person. What will make Tadi love me and want to choose me to become his partner is when I hustle in such a way that makes Tadi afraid. But when you go away as an employee, I don't want him to go. If I let him go, I may lose him. So I try as much as possible. So some people, truth of the matter is that they forget the real reason why they started working. They forget the reason why they are hustling.
No, like Tade usually says, he says it's because people are not hungry. And people are not hungry enough. But, so you think you are hungry, but you are actually not hungry. Because you see somebody that is giving you food.
Yeah.
Because when you don't see somebody that will give you food, your brain comes alive.
Yeah.
If in 2 days you didn't see any food to eat, and if you also have to buy water to drink, pure water, and you don't have 10 naira or 20 naira to buy pure water, your brain will come alive.
The part we are even talking about is that when people now do those things and they have that money, they forget the reason why they did that.
They totally forget.
So somebody is thinking that, you know what, I'm getting married now, because some people have been lied to.
that when they get married, they think their finances, everything will be in order. So you don't go and get married.
You know, that's one of the cultural mandates. That's one of the cultural mandates.
Cultural efficiency. And that's what I call it.
That's one of the cultural traps that people are living in. You know, it is a economic Armageddon. When you get into that state of your life, you know, where you are saying, you are putting scriptures upside down just to fulfill your financial foolishness. You know, so you are saying, now, like I said yesterday, I was in a church, they asked me to come and run a financial coaching for people that want to get married. And I will tell you for free, there are about 20, you know, put together in that room. And I realized that it's only one person or two, based on my financial analysis, that is qualified to marry. But you know what? Some of them came to me after the meeting. They were trying to convince themselves that it's by getting married that things will get
better.
That the things will get better. And then I looked at them and I said, oh, Jure, how much do you personally make right now every month? The guy said, one of them said nothing. Out of all of those people, one of them was respectful enough to withdraw from the marriage. Because I told him, I said, brother, you know what? Don't marry now. You don't need it. Sort your financial life first and foremost. And there's another set of people that are ladies that are broke, casted, you know, have no one naira or two naira in the bank account, have no money anywhere. All they are waiting for is one rich guy to come and marry them. As if there is a law written that a woman cannot be financially free. So they are waiting, they are like the family sometimes even tell them, I better marry the guy has money. Do you understand? You know the problem we have gone through all our life.
And
now
take care of us too.
Because people have not been told, people have not learned that, you see, what all that we are saying, the point is everybody can be financially free. Mm. The pattern, the system is so straightforward that the only thing missing is discipline. People are not disciplined enough to do what is necessary and whatever it takes to be able to follow this pattern. Number one, like what we're saying, like what all that you posted yesterday, fantastic post, talking about what really matter is the customer. Now, when you are working in an employment, you have a customer. It is your boss. But your boss have customers. Now, what you are doing is to help your boss to serve his customers. And by helping your boss to serve his customer, he get paid. Now, that means the point I ask people is take your financial, invest in yourself, and then begin to evaluate how is your asset? What are you using to earn money now? Because that is very, very important. A lot of people are not evaluating that. A young guy, a very sincere guy, sent me a message yesterday, and I love the message. He said he's looking for money to start his own printing business. And I say, what is important to you is starting a printing business? And the guy said, because he worked in a printing press. Mm-hmm. And I said, do you know that printing press now is fading away?
Yeah. Somebody sent a similar message to yesterday.
He said, people are still coming to the office to come. I said, but it's stealing. I said, let me tell you, it's stealing away. Why invest in a business that is already fading away? I mean, it is a mad kind of investment. When you know that business, everybody is looking for an emerging market, and then you are looking for a stable market to put your money in.
Why? Because that is the only thing that you know.
That is
so why not expose yourself beyond what you currently know? Because the reason for education is what you don't know, to gather what you don't know, not what you already know. So but people just want to still be educated in the things that they already know, instead of going for the things that they don't know. I did also did something like that yesterday. I asked people 2 days ago, I asked people, if I give you 250,000 naira, what are you going to do? I saw some lovely answers. But I only saw one person. That person, one person that gave this answer is not that remarkable. Do you understand? But I see a lot of people, because of the fact that you love something, you want to do that thing. I'm telling you, I want to give you 250,000 naira. What will you do now to be able to generate money now? And some sort of the things that you say you want to do, you're going to make money probably maybe in the next 2 years. You're telling me you want to do fashion, you want to do some fashion business, and I'm not saying that. Somebody say you want to do farming business. I'm saying you want to do this thing now, and what they're telling you is that you do farm, you do this particular farm, you do this particular farm, you do this. And you are doing like 7 different kinds of farm business. So that at the end of the day, I did farm business, I lost money. So if you are coming to tell me now that you want to do this same kind of business, and I know how much I lost maybe like 2.7 million and I'm trying to do the farm. Then you are coming to tell me, okay, 250,000. It's not because I got professionals involved in it. But it is beyond that. What are you going to do now? It is beyond what I know. It is understanding what I need to know for be able to, for me to become financially free. What do I need to do now for me to become financially free? Is to now gather information, come to me now. Like that part where you did, I think you also did a video on that too. Talking about, okay, making money now, making money later, soon, I'm making money later. If I have a pattern, because that is like a design. So what would I make if I have to sell, if communion is what I need to sell now to Catholic Church to make money now? I sell the communion now. I sell because I know that it is a now business, they will buy it. What are you doing now? What you have just done is that you have naturally multiplied that money now. Taking it to go and do something that you make money soon. It is a design, but you know what? People just like Dr. Bo, we talked about the other time. People just want to just, because they have an idea for what that for printing business. I want to go and do printing.
That's it.
I want to go and start publishing.
Technically, it's
true. I'm telling you, understand? So a lot of people don't know, because people do not still know what to do with their money. So that's why when money comes into their life, the first thing that they want to do is the first person that calls them on phone and tells them and appeal to them that, you know what, please can you send money now?
There's something about money. Yeah. Money has an aroma. That the moment you have it, it seems some people knows you are late. And then they begin to give you a strange call and say, sorry, somebody called me yesterday and said, sir, can I just get somebody to borrow me 600,000 to invest in my business and I will pay you back in 8 months? And I say no. One of the things I've learned to do as an investor is to say no. No must be romantic in your mouth as an investor, because people will bring stupid deals, people will bring sentimental deals, people will just believe, let me just give this idea to him, people just say, let me just bring this idea to him and maybe something will just happen. But this is it, because your money, your earnings, it's very important to you. What you do with your earnings is what determines your financial legacy.
Yeah.
And that's what a lot of people don't understand. So we just look at our earnings and we waste it. But some people listening to us now, the biggest challenge they have is to also work on their earnings.
Yeah.
A lot of people now, somebody sent me a message 2 days ago and I love the guy, so I'm trying to address his problem now. The guy sent me a post, you can say that he earns about maybe 70,000, he's earning 60,000 a monthly, and then he saved 15,000 every month. I give him kudos for that. And then his yearly rent is 80,000, okay? And then when you look at that, he has 45,000 there to spend. I've asked him a question he has not been able to answer. I said, what do you do with the 45,000? And then what do you do with the 15,000 there savings that you are making? Because you know what, you don't save to save, you save to prosper. You save to invest so that you can grow rich. So you don't, people save for emergency, that's why emergencies show up in their life.
Yeah.
Because what you save for is an attraction. That's what a lot of people don't know. What you save for is an attraction, what you save for will show up. So if you are saving for emergency will show up. If you are saving to pay your student school fee, the school fee will show up. If you are saving so that your friend party can be, your friend will tune to a party and you can buy the clothes, it will soon show up. And if you are saving to get an opportunity that will make you rich, it will show up too. So what you save for will show up. So a lot of times there is another institution called a conspiracy that is telling people everywhere, save. That thing stops. You know, because it sucks. Why did it suck? Because the question is, when people are saving,
what are they saving for?
They save to you as a financial institution, you are using their money to multiply, to make more money, and you give them nothing. Nigeria don't give you money for
them. You give them peanuts. Not 0.1%.
Peanut can be filled. Peanut, this one.
0.1%.
Give them a mustard seed that cannot be planted.
There's an account that I'm choosing not to add money into. I just choose. I have like, I think maybe like 3,000 inside that account. And every time I get text message.
Debit?
No, I got text message this morning. Who there for credit? And as soon as you get
you see debit.
And immediately you are seeing credit, you are seeing debit. I've done an account like that for maybe like this is gonna be.
Are you serious?
Year. This is gonna be the 3rd year. It's to tell you that the financial institutions are not gonna help you.
No, it's a conspiracy.
That's the part of you talking about the saving. What exactly am I saving for? We've been involved in
lectures on people should save and all of that. But you know what? It doesn't help anybody. It has never helped anybody. If we look at the history of maybe our society, in every community, every village that we all come from, there are people who are called who borrow money lenders, Ususu, Esusu, and all of that. In every community you find them, in every village. No matter how poor the village is, that person who collects that money, for people, do you know what he uses it for? He needs to go and produce, work on his own farm. You keep your money with him, he will come and borrow you after he has sold the yam. He's the one who has the largest, used to have the largest farm land. And at the end of the day, you use your money, he gives you back. You don't know what he does with that money, but you just think that this person is a sincere person.
That's what our bank, that's what Nigerian bank does. They collect your money, they want you to save.
Yeah.
You save the money with them, you know, and they are using your money. They're using your money to make money for themselves, literally. Nigerian banks is not a bank. I've said it over time. You know what? Rather, they use your money to make a lot of money for themselves. And you know what? Why you are just there? Now, the question is, are we saying that you should spend all your money? No, because the first law is the law of earning. The second law is the law of saving. But you save for investment. You don't just save for saving. You don't save to feel, I have some money in account. Let's emergency show up, I will spend it.
Like there's something that I did when I realized that thing. What has happened to me? It's not because I wasn't making money. Because you know what? I don't know them. I don't know. Money goes like this. Money comes like this. I know how much I earn on working this, but I don't know exactly where it goes. So you know what? I want to create a system whereby let me even know where it is going to. I created like a 7 structure. I call it basket. This basket is for housekeeping. This basket is for social. This basket is for investment. This basket is for this one. Even if my company has personal issue, but I won't have personal issue. Why? Because I have my own personal investment.
You're taking care of your personal
and my personal investment is maybe takes larger percentage. I have what I call for my education. I have a budget for education. Why? My children's education, my own personal education, my wife's education. So you don't ask me, so I know what school to put my children into. It's not that maybe because I want to be part one of the choices. I know what my commitment is, so I already know what I need. So I want my children to attend this particular school. I know what my income currently is. I know what my income should be for me to be able to achieve that. Because our needs increases over time.
Absolutely.
So for us to be able, we need to be able to know, okay, what kind of income do I need to now start creating for me to be able to meet that need? Because like what you said, now income expenses are the
financial problems of life.
They are always with us on the daily basis. Whether I retire financially or whether I retire agely or whatever, it is always a companion. So for me, before you are born, they spend money on you. They spend money on you. So when you are not,
you are putting the
spend money on him. Someone dies,
they spend money on you.
So it's the constant effect. So you know what? Create that so that then from there I now realize, okay, oh, you know what, I can't be spending 30% of my money on investment. I need to start spending close to about 50% of my money on investment. Because I know the kind of life I want to live. I know the kind of income that I want. I know the kind of things that I want to do. So, okay, will I be able to do this if I do? So I started doing all of that. And that's helped me a bit because, you know what, someone can be any close to about 500,000 and I still remain poor.
Yeah, because your earnings will not make you rich. Your earnings only reveals your level of, you know, your demand for your product in the market. However, that does not make you rich. It's the financial education you have to now know the multiplier effect of your money. And you know, I like the system you have created, and I think people need to come out and ask for this system so that this basket is very, very important that you have created. Because the truth is, I say this again and again, that every family needs to have family economy solid. Yeah. And it needs to be done once in a month. You see, we live in a society where people don't know their financial freedom day. They know Independence Day. They know May Day. They know all of those things. But ask them, what is the financial freedom?
Maybe we don't call our own financial economy, economy summit. I'll start calling it that.
Yeah. Okay.
But every Sunday, my wife and I will try as much as possible to sit down. So I know that my wife, because like there's also one part that you talked about where a lot of people don't
their spouse, the people don't even know what they earn. Before I got married, my wife knew what my earn. You know that there's no way we can do this.
You send money to my account this morning, my wife.
But what they even do now is they undo the financial implications of the family because you need one person in the family, not even that, because we all need to know.
Because we all need to be part of
it.
It's a nation. Like Chris Obama would say,
you know, the family is a nation. Yeah. So you need to know one of the pillars of that nation is your finances.
Yeah.
So you need to know the state of nation. And you see, it's whatever that you measure that you can manage.
Yeah.
So it's whatever that you manage that you can improve. Yeah. So the earlier you can measure it, the whether you are looked at where financial aid you are, the faster we can get out of it.
So do what my wife can do, she can help me go and get. She can even help me to prospect for a client. Because she knows that, okay, I'm from Lorraine.
See, my wife now has about three streams of income now. Mm-hmm. You know why? Because the truth is, my wife knows, I teach my wife that, babe, you know what? I don't need your money. But you earn money for your own personal esteem.
Yeah.
It is good that you earn your money. It is good because you are a human being, you are not a robot.
Yeah.
You know, so it is one of the proof that you are doing something to the society. Mm-hmm. So my wife create project, my wife, you know, sell things, my wife has systems to sell things. You know why? The money is with her. I've told her, okay, put your money in this process. So, because you know why? If all that you do with your wife is to have sex with your wife, you are not bigger than an animal. Yeah. You know, because if all that you do, because it's only animal, don't animal you have a non-verbal conversation.
The next thing, okay, I bring in money so that I can have sex. I bring in money so that we can just have sex now. In technical way. That you're trying to prostitute yourself.
The
truth of the matter is that everybody in the family needs to be able to know what the income is. And I told myself that when my children get to be age of 4, they must understand the mindset of money.
Education of the rich.
They must understand it. Because you know what? I quickly understood, but nobody taught me. But I knew that we were poor. Mm. I knew that we were so poor because I was seeing bed bugs everywhere. My children may not see bed bugs. But you know what? I was able to see poverty firsthand. So poverty taught me.
Life and direct.
I know what? And you also see some other children on the street that has better health and better than you.
I know what you're saying.
So you saw it too. You bring it upon yourself to learn. But sometimes my children may not have that kind of opportunity because I count it as an opportunity because I learned from it.
Yeah.
So my children may not have that opportunity, but I want them to understand that. That process of, you know what? What is money? How do you make money? How do you multiply money? How do you keep money? If they can figure these three things out,
they're fine. And they can be anywhere in the world.
You can make progress in life.
You know, one of the things I created in the last couple of 1 week now is what I call it the street warriors. And the essence of the street warriors is to begin to, people don't know how to make money in the real world, especially people that are coming out of school. And one of the subtle things that school will do to you is to make you become arrogant. You believe that you have gone to school, and that's why once I've seen this narrative where a young girl that is just coming out of school, out of university now, he saw a man or a man that is maybe a bricklayer or is selling meat, and then they are now talking, now say, you this illiterate. Yes. Excuse me, when you use the word illiterate loosely, you're also an illiterate.
Yes.
Because you see, the word illiterate, it does not necessarily, it's not encompassing. Somebody can be an illiterate in speaking English. But you that have gone to school, you are also an illiterate because you don't even know about what you know. It's not going to school now. If you have gone to school, you will know better. So a lot of time people get those things. And like you are saying, people don't, they say there is a crisis on the way, and there is a crisis that has arrived. You know, and a lot of people don't really, really get these things. And people wake up every day, and one of the things that religion can do to you if you are not careful is that religion can make you escape reality. And you know, because that's not spirituality, as it were. Spirituality will help you to face reality, help you to know that this is a resistance, we need to scale it. But your religion helped you to say, no. Let's forget this thing. Let's just stay with this. Something will be happening. It will happen one day.
What affects others
will not affect me. And then you are really killed. You know why? Because imagine that Noah did not build the ark.
What about Noah?
Noah is not in charge of the rain. Noah is in charge of the ark.
He's not in charge of the rain.
Noah is not in charge of the rain. You are not in charge of the national economy. You are not in charge. You are in charge of your own. If Noah has not gone to build the ark, Noah will have sank and humanity will have been drowned. That is the end of it. Noah's instruction is work on the ark. Build the ark. It's not analysis that leads to paralysis. He said, no, when is rain coming? Hey, no, there's no rain now.
So the weather is not showing.
The weather is not showing like it will rain.
It's not, we are not in mid year. We are not in mid year.
Somebody was asking me yesterday, can
rain
be falling in November?
They're not in charge.
In my mind, I'm like, am I supposed to know that?
I prepare yourself every day. You prepare yourself every day because you know what? It doesn't give you, don't give you signal sometimes.
You know, because that's why.
Don't give you signal.
Yesterday's rain didn't give signal.
The crisis around town does not give signal.
That's why people are in financial storm. Mm-hmm. One of the things that help you break out of financial storm is financial understanding. Mm-hmm. And you know what? Financial understanding is what you prepare for. You don't prepare for the understanding when the storm comes. You prepare for the understanding before the storm. And I want people to see us the way we study, the way we experiment, the way we do what we do, is because you know why? You see, storm does not give invitation card. It comes anytime. You know what? And storm, what storm does is to make people that are prepared to become an hero and to make victim of those people that are not prepared. Storm is not bad, not good. Storm is just a position. It's just a position. It just happened. It's not bad or good. It is how you are positioned yourself.
You don't want the storm, go and create your own planet.
Do you understand? If you don't want the storm, create your own planet, my friend. Create your own planet. You know why? But the storm, it is, there will be contraction, there will be expansion. There will be plenty time, there will be lean time. The question is not those things. You are not in control of those things. You are not in control of the wind. You are not in control of the wind. You are in control of sailing your own boat. That is your responsibility as human being. And you know what? Like we often say here, there are three kinds of business. God's business. God's business is the business of storm. God's business is the business of rain. God's business is the business of the wind. That is the business of nature. It's not your business. You know what? Don't forget it. The reason why you are having headache and
you are not even needed.
They know why you're in the hospital, they don't know what is your problem. It's because you're trying to handle God's business for God. The second business is your business. Your business, your personal economy, building your own eye, getting educated, what you do with your money, how you learn how to invest, create rental income for yourself, that is your business. And the other business is other people's business. You know why? Today is making billions of naira. Today is building rental properties everywhere. Who is he? Why is he just exposing himself everywhere online? Why is he just doing that? Is Today's business, not your business. You see, there are two things that will give you heart attack, not your business. If you focus on God's business and you focus on other people's business, there's only two that will give you rest of mind. Focus on your business. And that's why a lot of people are poor today. They are broke. You know why? They are focusing on peacemakers' economy when they should be minding their own economy. They are focusing on truth's economy when they should be minding their own economy. It is what God has given us and what God is going to judge us on is how you mind your own economy. Mind your business. It is not an insulting word. It's a changing word. Mind your own business.
And if you can take it as an insulting word, good luck to you.
You need
to
mind your own business. Don't be busybody, my friend. You see, there are many financial busybodies in town. They are learning nothing. They are not building their own economy. They don't understand.
They are attacking every
other. Last time they have read any concretized book is when they graduated from school. And I know many people thought they have experience because they have worked in a company for 10 years. But what they do is that they have 1 year experience and they repeated 10 times. You know, that's all. They thought they have experience. Because experience is not by going through a thing. Experience is by growing through a thing. So a lot of people don't have experience in life. They're just accumulating one experience, repeating it. So they are poor, they are broke. And I said to people that, you know what, if I lose everything I have today, excuse me, sir, come back in 2 years' time. Because the real financial security is not in possession. The real financial security is in the understanding that the capacity I have, if I lost all that I have, I can rebuild it. That is the real security. The real security is not the money. The real security is knowing how the money comes.
What you just said just remind me of Jesus. Say this thing will come in 3 days, I'll give you job. It's not just a spiritual statement. Sometimes, and when you make that kind of statement, they'll say, oh, maybe you're holding on
Jeremy. Proud.
There's only control back only. You're not knowing that there are certain things.